Well, we're going to turn now to the tragedy at the Jersey Shore. Investigators trying to figure out what caused the massive blaze that destroyed one of the most famous boardwalks in the world. The fire still smoldering after wiping out dozens of businesses just getting back on their feet after Hurricane Sandy. And ABC's Gio Benitez is at the scene at Seaside Heights with the very latest. Gio.
Good morning to you, Bianna. This fire, we're told, is being treated as suspicious. That's what sources tell ABC News. And this morning, we have new video that could give investigators the information they need.
Your store's on fire.
Don't go in there.
This morning, investigators may be poring over this cell phone video, capturing the start of that massive blaze at the Coors Custard Shop at the Funtown Pier.
About how this fire started, we don't know yet. And it would be irresponsible for any of us to speculate.
From the air, the massive and widespread devastation stretches for blocks, 30 buildings destroyed in the heart of the Jersey Shore. From the ground, tears watching childhood memories go up in flames.
Watching a bunch of memories wiped out in ashes.
30-mile-per-hour winds pushed the fast-moving flames north into Seaside Heights, where last year that iconic roller coaster ended up in the sea following Superstorm Sandy. So much of this had been rebuilt, but this morning the charred debris is a devastating reminder of the pain just months ago.
Sandy was enough for us. Now that we just got done rebuilding, the fire came and took that away too.
The flames stopped by quick-thinking heroes.
This is where firefighters broke through the boardwalk to stop that fire from moving any further north. And all that's left somewhat intact, carnival signs like this one.
New Jersey Governor Chris Christie visited the businesses on the boardwalk, consoling the heartbroken. In May, he was here as well, showing Prince Harry how far the Jersey Shore had come since Sandy. Now he finds himself thanking the brave firefighters who put out the blaze.
400 of them stopped this thing in its tracks, or everything we've rebuilt could have been gone.
And just take a look behind me. There is so much cleaning up to do this morning, but investigators are still in there collecting evidence, and we're told there are still hot spots in that rubble, Dan.
Really sad to see, and a lot of questions still this morning. Gio, thank you.